This is Crazy today. Welcome back to another DevLog. Today, I am going to be doing something a bit different. I have actually started a brand new mod. The reason why is because if I go to MCreator right here, recently someone posted, Freddy Fox Gamer, they posted this, the RPG Challenge. So basically, I have entered in, and the mod is due by March 31st, 2021. So we do have some time. If you don't want to join this, all you have to do is just leave a reply to the forum on here for the forum topic, and then just create your mod. And these right here are the minimum requirements. You can check these out yourself by pausing the video, or as I said, I'll leave the link in the description of this page. But yes, I have created a brand new mod. It is already huge. I have worked on it for a couple of days now. And actually, I have not worked on it for about 2 days-ish because I wanted to make this video where I would test some of the features. And if you guys actually want to test this mod, I will link, if you have a CurseForge or an MCreator, I will give you credit for testing the mod because it is always greatly appreciated. If this video gets 5 likes, I will upload it to maybe like MediaFire where you can download the mod. I'll probably put it in a zip file, also with some instructions on how to use it and stuff. But yeah, here we have this thing called the Dark World. This is not the final name, and I already know the final name of it. I'm just not going to put it on here because, not yet at least, because this right here is like the earliest of InDevs. Or not the earliest of InDevs. Earliest was a long time ago. We just update it because every day I actually add another one on here, but I already made some larger changes, so every single time I try to test it, I just add another digit to that. So yeah, as you can see here, we have some brand new ores. Also, we have some screenshots. This right here is the first screenshot, which has a picture of the early ores. Another early ore, and then this right here is a screenshot of what the ores currently look like. So yeah, what I'm going to be doing in this video is I'm just going to be, it's going to be kind of showcasing off these. This brand new dimension which I have created, which will be basically, it'll fit into the lore of Magician's Awakening. So it will kind of be a continuation to that, but Magician's Awakening was never really big, so internal RPG, creative, definitely not hardcore. So to create the portal, it's going to be made of obsidian that I have already kind of thought out, and it will be lit, also with a flint and steel. But instead of going to the nether, there's also going to be some conditions instead. So there's going to be some special things to it. So there we go. Your inner world. I have really lowered down the settings so I can actually get mediocre performance, like 70 frames per second. So yeah. So what we're going to do, we're going to get our obsidian. We're going to go to tools. And see here, we just have some reinforced stuff. I'll explain about that more in a bit. This right here is the basically development tool to light the portal. You can make this just like that. And boom. See here, just using one of the InDev version 1 textures that I've dubbed it. But I have changed the textures a lot. So yeah. This right here is what the biome looks like. You can see it has mushrooms up here and taller mushrooms. So this is definitely not the final version. There's going to be a lot of varying stuff with this. Also, there isn't going to be one biome. Right here is just one biome right here. And also, as you can see here, the really, really rough generation stuff because of my biome blend. You kind of have to have a higher biome blend. I don't know why, but it just doesn't really do a good job in the MCreator testing servers. But yeah. Honestly, here I have a brand new stone type. And this right here is just regular grass, but this right here is called Blackstone. And Blackstone will actually have the special ores I have in here. So let me just scroll down to the bottom. We have Black Iron. This right here is also Black Iron. I will tell you the names of these at the end of the video. So if you want to stick around, I will show you those. But Black Iron is just like regular iron, except it is a bit stronger, like diamonds. This right here, the other Black Iron, is going to be kind of like, it's going to be the same as Black Iron, but it's going to have a special fire ability with it. This right here is another black iron. This right here is the other ore, and this right here will have magical capabilities, and then this right here is the strongest base ore, kind of like diamonds. But also, we do have some special stuff here. We also have Eternalium and Strangwin. And these two are actually alloys. And alloys is something I actually kind of experimented in a pretty old mod. Let me just see if I can find it. Pretty sure it was called TechCraft. Just make sure that this is the correct one. Yep, it is. Because Crispy Chips commented on it because he was also making a mod called Alloy. So as you can see here, we actually have some alloys, which was basically the thing about this mod. But yeah, I will be re-adding alloys to Minecraft in a lot better way. So yeah. So that is basically the random dimension, stuff like that. So now I guess I'll just go over some of the names of the items. So we can just go over these. We have Amber, which is a new ore. Black Iron, of course. Dark Gem, which is not a new ore, it will be a drop. Pandixite, I'm definitely going to rename a lot of these. Just like Netherite, I will be removing Netherite once MCreator or MC Toolkit, or whatever the next MCreator successor will be. I'll probably be removing that once the next thing updates to 1.16. We have Eternalium, which is the alloy. Everflare. We have Opal. Aurelium, which will spawn in the overworld. Pearl. Ruby. Sapphire. Soul, which will be a drop. Solon, which is an ingot. And Strangwin, as well as Topaz and Umbrum. Okay, let's see here. There's a lot of other stuff that I can cover right now, but yeah. Honestly, as you can see, you can actually see where they're going to spawn. So Aurelium will spawn in the overworld. Ruby will spawn also in the overworld, as well as Sapphire. Pearl and Opal will also spawn in the overworld. Netherite, as well as Amber, will spawn in the end. And Dixite and Topaz will spawn in the end as well. And then Black Iron, Everflare, Umbrum, and Solon will spawn in the brand new dimension, which I currently have as Dark World. So yeah, that's basically the first, I guess, devlog of this brand. The mod, I'm just making sure I don't accidentally hit delete on that. Oh god. But yeah, as you can see here, I am going to be developing this mod for quite a while. And yeah, I want to thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you're my channel, I'd be really appreciated if you were to subscribe. Oh, and also I actually have some quick news. I have created a brand new channel called Game Voyager. Right now, I have put it on pause because I'm going to be working more on this channel because we're about to hit 300 subscribers. So I thank you so much for this. And also the reason why I haven't uploaded for like 20 days is because I've been busy with schoolwork and studying. But I will be trying to upload a bit more. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this video. See you guys all next time, and goodbye, guys.